Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the pumping capacity of the heart. We know that with increasing venous return, the cardiac output increases. But it cannot increase indefinitely. There is a limit. We can study that limit in the cardiac output curve. It shows right atrial pressure on the x-axis and the cardiac output on the y-axis. This is the normal cardiac output curve. We have already seen how an increase in right atrial pressure causes an increase in cardiac output in a video on regulation of cardiac output. So we won't go into that detail again. Here we will focus on the curve. This curve is for normal human heart functioning without any kind of nervous influence. Here we can see that with increase in right atrial pressure, initially the cardiac output increases, but eventually it reaches a plateau and there is no further increase in cardiac output even with the increase in pressure. For a normal heart, this maximum capacity is reached at about 13 liters per minute. However, this curve can shift up or down in different situations. So let's study them. First, let's talk about the factors that make the heart hypereffective. Here, first factor is the nervous excitation of the heart. An increase in sympathetic activity or decrease in parasympathetic activity to the heart causes an increase in heart rate and an increase in the force of contraction. So, the capacity to pump out blood increases. The next factor rising this curve is hypertrophy of the heart. When there is a long-term increase in the workload on the heart, its muscle mass and contractile strength increases. Such factors can increase the plateau level up to 25 liters per minute independently. And when combined, they can increase the maximum output up to 40 liters per minute. So these were the factors that make the heart hypereffective. Now let's see the factors that make the heart hypoeffective. It happens in pathological conditions like hypertension, in which heart has to pump against higher atrial pressure, arrhythmia, coronary artery disease, valvular heart disease, congenital heart diseases, myocarditis, etc. They lower the cardiac output curve. So, the maximum cardiac output cannot increase as much as it can under normal circumstances. So, this was all about cardiac output curves. In summary, the cardiac output increases with an increase in right atrial pressure. But there is a limit to this. A normal heart without nervous stimulation can increase its output up to 13 liters per minute. Nervous stimulation and hypertrophy can increase this capacity. In various pathological conditions, decrease this capacity. Now, for sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. For a normal heart, mechanisms like Franz-Starling mechanism of the heart play a major role in increasing cardiac output. But with a sympathetic stimulation, mechanisms like calcium loading in myocardiocytes are also added. So this allows even greater increase in cardiac output. So that's it for this video. Please hit all the YouTube buttons that you see below this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.